First frame. Dave Gilbert to break.
E vamos pro jogo, né, galera? Bom dia a todos.
Thank you, Hazel.
Deus abençoe o nosso dia.
And, well, what a great atmosphere.
77.
And to look at the audience now, absolutely out to capacity. It was just a few people here that first morning, I remember. But Ken, we're asking the question now about Luka. When you came back after winning in 97, 98, did you try and relive those thoughts of the emotion, or did you try and keep it under control?
Yeah, well, that's a good question, John. You know,
it
was such a great year as world champion. Yeah, I'm very proud to be champion. And you're sort of desperate to keep it for another year, to hold on to that trophy, and you do. Well, you got. He has to rely on those wonderful memories from last year. Everybody's going to talk about the Crucible Course, there's no doubt about that. And that brings its own pressure. Live on those great memories from last year, and just the way he played. It was just inspirational stuff. But he's up against a tough opponent, as we all know, Dave Gilbert. Came through the qualifying rounds, played really well. And it might actually help him, John. You know, when you've got like a really tough match in the beginning, that, you know, that it could go either way.
Well, yeah. It certainly sharpened the senses. I've just watched the first three shots, the safety from Dave Gilbert and the two positional shots from Luka. This table is quick. It looks like a skating rink out there.
Luka Brasel, 6.
Yeah, and in fairness, even the clots up at the English Institute of Sport, they were playing beautifully. Lots of good breaks, lots of players talking about the conditions. The clots have been really good this year. The table fitters have done a great job. And let's hope it's going to be conducive to really good snooker and big breaks. Great atmosphere in here. It's such a special place, John. You know, the crowd, first morning of the Crucible, the World Championship, the atmosphere, the anticipation, the build-up to it as well. It's just magnificent.
Bit of a stalemate at the moment, and it's going to be made worse, the fact that that red has gone near the ball cushion. So there's no safety in that area. So we could be bogged down for a few shots here.
Mais um pouquinho.
Because it could go in off the other red if it doesn't go in directly. There you go.
Oh, ai, que azar, cara.
That's unlucky.
Já deu uma cagada na bola 1 e... Putz. Olha, a bola não, ele tentou a gaveta, quase que não consegue, mas caiu a bola 3.
Unbelievable,
that's right, John Virgo.
One.
Yeah, I think the good thing is, I'll stop the stalemate now, and a good chance here for Luka. Okay. Pack pretty tight. But if you can get a nice angle on his next colour off this red.
3.
When he potted the yellow, he could have played the cannon on the red and the blue that were together and brought the blue into play. 4. It has still been on that red, he's just potted. As we're saying, you know, just need to settle down, probably think, take no risk, just get the cue arm going. This time he had a good angle on the green. How have they broke? Looked very good to me.
Inch perfect.
7.
Wonderful shot. Wonderful shot.
8.
Olha, tem tudo para fechar o frame.
Just a glancing half ball blow off that pink. Perfect. And this is what he would have wanted starting off this match. Good chance. Try and win the frame from one visit. Angle on the black.
Yeah, one visit.
See, it's a bit straight. So
one visit para os caras é fechar o jogo. Uma visita na mesa e cuida a fatura.
15. 16.
Not a great angle on the green this time, so it's going to need a precise positional shot. Just a bit short. Still got this red to the right corner. He'll be using the rest.
Yeah, I think he's on rest, man. Tá aí o rest.
He's definitely not guaranteed to be on a color here. Might not be worth taking on this red. But he doesn't refuse much, Luca Brasel. How is he going to get a color here? Get on the color, something like that. What a shot.
Well, brave shot.
Yeah.
He deserved that little bit
of corajoso mesmo.
Say it was. I mean, I know he played the cannon, but to be on the black as he was a bonus, let's put it that way. But
27. Yeah.
Had the courage and belief to play it, so deserves all he gets now.
28.
Funny enough, I know people said that he's had a bad season, but I was commentating on the Welsh Open, and there were certainly signs there that he was back to his best. He didn't go on to win the tournament, but certainly showed me that he was queuing well enough.
Yeah, I think the last couple of months, showing some sort of signs. I mean, it's been a pretty lean season by his own standards. Only one final at the beginning at Shanghai Masters, and then of course the final, the Rio.
35 pontos na mesa.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, he played really.
Duas vermelhas para ele. Precisa de duas vermelhas para.
Definitely signs, good signs for him.
Duas vermelhas para garantir o frame.
And this is a good start. Should win the frame now from this visit. Settle them down.
43.
He's such 44. A shot maker as well, isn't he? I mean, he really captured the hearts of all the snooker fans last year. Just the way he played, the manner in which he won the championship. I mean, that the semi-final, the match against Ronnie, I think, started off, didn't it, John? And where he won seven frames in a row.
Yeah, 10-6 behind going into the third session, and. Won all seven frames.
67 pontos na mesa, essa é a bola do frame.
And then just went on from 51. That. I mean, his match against Si Jiu Wei, what's all that about? What was he, 14-5 behind, was
14 it? 14-5 behind, yeah. Forced to 17.
Talk about having your name written on the trophy. Amazing comeback.
É isso que ele está falando. Enquanto o Si Jiu Wei, ano passado, ele estava perdendo de 14-5. 14-5 behind. Ele estava atrás, perdendo para o Si Jiu Wei de 14-5 e virou o jogo.
Very talented.
Eu quem lembro do ano passado, né? O ano passado o Luca Brasel ganhou 13 frames seguidos. Vai ganhar de 18 a 14. Quem lembra disso aí? Ele foi demais mesmo. Na semifinal, né?
62.
Well, first frame, we could see a century here. It's on. Blue will be the problem.
É, mas pode dar uma tacada centenária mesmo. 66 pontos na tacada.
And I mentioned early on, Ken, that the table looked like a skating rink, the way the balls were rolling on, but
vamos ver como é que está o jogo do Luke Jambiada.
Has now found the pace of the table.
Yeah. For everything that he does have possess, and he's got great cue power, Luca Brasel, but he's got a wonderful touch. And
74.
Got great control of that cue ball. But he can play the depth shots. There's one. A little bit of side, just get the nice angle on the black. But he can play all the shots. There's not a shot he can't play.
É, Jiang Yanda tá 39-24 pro Jiang Yanda. Tem 7 vermelhas na mesa, 83 pontos na mesa.
Tá.
Bom dia, Manuel. Seja bem-vindo. Tudo jóia? Então, Zé, mano, o Luca Bressel, o Romano, o primeiro atacado centenário do dia, hein?
Oh, it's perfect on the green to do that. Just screw back a couple of inches.
87.
That looks perfect. Now it's all about. If he's perfect, he can pop the brown, come off the side cushion, and just nudge the blue away from it. So no pace. Well, he's looking for the middle, but he's got a chance of it into this right corner. What a start. Blue and pink to start with a ton. It's there.
Ooh.
Oh, it's not there. But what a start for Luca Brasil.
Para você que gosta de produtos de qualidade, conheça as solas MP Tips, fabricadas de forma artesanal, um produto nacional, feitas em couro de búfalo com durezas que vão de média a dura. E sob encomenda, você pode escolher a dureza da sua sola. Também temos solas laminadas feitas com couro de porco. Entre em contato com o Pedro Mendonça, melhore seu jogo com produtos de qualidade.
Esperando, juizão, tá moçando. Look at myself to break.
The second frame, Luca Brasil to break.
Vamos lá pro segundo frame. Olha que saída. Beleza, Bota. É, eu acho que é o microfone, mas vamos tentar arrumar. A voz hoje está ruim.
Bad break off from Luca Brasil. Have a look at the cue ball.
Yeah, and not guaranteed to get this safe. There's a few loose reds about, so you're going to get line and length just right. Trying to make contact with the red just to the left of the black. Good line, but not hard enough.
Foul.
Foul and miss.
So Luca thinking, well, next time he might just overhit it or misjudge it.
Eu só fala menos.
Might run around the back of the black to leave me a pot on. So no hesitation, having it replaced.
Legal, legal.
First attempt to me was the perfect line. Just needs a bit more pace.
Show. É, saiu com.
This time he's gone narrow and it's run up.
E deixou.
That red goal.
Não era pra estar, né, velho? O cara é experiente, né, cara?
Lawrence has to get out of the way. Luca wants to have a look from the pocket angle. It's very, very
não
tight.
Era pra estar, não.
Yeah, at first glance, I thought it did. It does to me. Well, it's tight, though, as you say.
Ih, rapaz. Na outra mesa, o Jack Jones.
But in it went. What?
Na outra mesa, o Jack Jones está... Ih, rapaz. Três vermelhas na mesa, o Jack Jones na atacada, já com 19 pontos na atacada, até com 43. É a quarta, vez que o...
Just for the red, just above the black.
O David Gilbert chega no cross one.
Nine.
Opportunity. Early on in the second frame for Luca Brasil.
Well, it could have been a little straight on this red. I don't think he can. We look at that wonderful scene. There you see, if he was straight, just a formality run through. If he plays it, he's going to be kissing into other reds. Can he judge the cannon? Perfectly.
17.
Don't want to get too excited. This will be three reds, three blacks. frame priority. Try and win in one visit without thinking about maximum just yet. That's okay. He played that little kiss on the red, and if he hit that red full ball, he'd still be on the red into the bottom right 24. Corner, but he's on this red into the left center. He'll screw back for the black here.
É, vai dar uma puxadinha pra bola 7.
25.
Once again, just a little bit straight on the black here. A little shake of the head. Angle's not great.
Yeah, and it's the worst one. Someone once said to me, what do you mean by just off straight? Well, if it was straight, he could screw back off the side cushion, but just...
Tá quase reta, né?
Being off straight... The straight screw back kisses the red that's just above the cue ball. So as you say, not perfect. Needs to do something with the white here. Middle, which I'm certain it does.
32.
It's even got one to the right corner. Well, one to the right middle looks the best one for position. He thinks not, so... And the pink's available.
Vai jogar bola 6 no meio.
Yeah, so that's the end of any thoughts of a maximum, but as I said, priority is to win the frame from one visit. Pink won't go on its spot, so we'll have to go at the back of the pack and closest to its own spot and line with the black.
Referee Paul Collier putting the pink in the position. He's got the final this year.
Yeah, as last year, 39. As a referee. Been refereeing for over 30 years, Paul Collier. Great servant to the game. And fitting, I think, John, no doubt. Finish off in style.
Yeah, good referee. And as they all say, the best referees are heard and not seen.
Jack Jones está ganhando do...
I'll put him up in the top 10 for that.
Jack Jones está na frente do... Jung Yanda em 47-39, só tem duas vermelhas na mesa.
But meanwhile, back at the table, Luca Brasel...
47.
Really going through the ball beautifully here. Always a good feeling for any player when the pots are going right in the heart of the pocket.
Yeah, last of the loose reds, not the best
55.
Angle. Still got a bit of work to do. He's gonna need to open up that pack of reds if he's going to win the frame from this visit. Oh, cue ball needs to slow down.
56.
He's okay. Now he'd love a shot similar to the one he played on the other side of the table, on the green, in the first frame. A glancing blow off these reds. How's your luck?
It could have been worse. He's got this red to the left middle. He's got a little bit of work to do with the cue ball, which makes the pot difficult, and the fact that the cue ball is a bit closer to the side cushion than he would like. But as I say, it could have been worse. At least he's got something to go at, and he's going to go for it. And if he knocks it in, gets on the collar, that should be the second frame in the bag.
Wonderful shot.
Wonderful pot. Very missable.
Wonderful pot.
It's a great start from the defending champion.
75 pontos na mesa, a bola do frame é essa. Frame ball.
Opening two frames.
Ah, o campeonato, esse é o mundial, é assim mesmo, viu, Manuel? Aparecem as crianças, os jovens, é muito legal, cara.
Chance early in the next frame.
2-0.
Oh, first frame, only 11 minutes, 9 minutes so far this frame. It's
9 minutos o frame.
Can you keep the break going? I guess he can. Good start.
73.
And the century is on now.
Aí, ó, pode ter o centro, hein? Ih, rapaz, na outra mesa o.
Quem diria, hein?
Jack Jones faz 1-0 no. 1-0, praticamente 1-0, tá com. 29 pontos de frente, tem 27 na mesa, já tá afogado. 25 pontos na mesa e tá limpando as mesas. Mais colorida.
Very impressive.
Na outra mesa, 1-0, Jack Jones.
Yes,
Ih, rapaz, saca o Jang Yanda, não vai passar do primeiro round?
The type of tables that the players love, don't you? You can just stroke the ball, you don't have to be hitting them hard. As long as you get the right top spin or back spin on the cue ball. And he's making the game look very easy.
He's playing with a nice pace as well, isn't he? He looks very focused. Concentration seems to be spot on. Here's the century. Great stuff from the defending champion, Luca Brasil. Wonderful start to this match.
100. Same points.
101.
Spin it. Almost.
107.
Quase, faltou pouquinho.
Double. Double into the green pocket. Pretty close. Is it there? Oh!
Yeah. 109.
Olha o Harry Potter ali na plateia. Tem até o Harry Potter tá ali.
112.
And that's what the crowd love to see, no doubt about it. As well as the big breaks, but they love to see the shots, the different entertaining shots. And Luca is one of those players. Here's another one.
116.
Has he got the pace of the table, do you think?
Na hora, bela tocada.
Just about, I think, John, just about.
$127.
There was pressure on the defending champion. What pressure. What a break. $134 for Luca Brasil, the defending champion. He's up and running.
2-0. Fala pessoal, pra gente que gosta desse nosso esporte, sabe o quanto é difícil encontrar links que contenham lives, jogos ao vivo. É comum a gente ver nos grupos do WhatsApp perguntas do tipo, alguém tem um link? Onde que tá assistindo? Onde que eu posso assistir? E isso você encontra aqui no nosso canal Pizza Pava Sinuca. Você pode fazer parte do nosso grupo de membros do canal, onde você tem acesso a conteúdos exclusivos, transmissões ao vivo exclusivas. Um abraço!
Pena que, mas é aquele cara que não tem sangue no olho, né? Não tem...
The third frame. Dave Gilbert to break.
Primeira vez que eu vi o David Gilbert, eu falei, pô, será que o Roger Waters está jogando também? É, velho.
Yeah, you would think any nerves that he brought to the table with him this morning, Luca.
Campeão do mundo, né? Ele tem que mostrar serviço.
He's showing everybody here at the Crucible why he comes in as defending champion.
Só quem gosta de música boa vai entender essa do Roger Waters, hein?
First frames. Two cushion escape with pace. Judged to perfection. If he misses the brown, he's perfect. Wonderful. Yeah, what a scene, eh? What theater.
Na outra partida, o Jack Jones ganhou do... Ganhou do Zhang Yan, em 1-0 pro Jack Jones, hein? Surpresa,
nice shot there from Dave. I remember, and this is the nature of snooker, he's not had his hand on the table much. Okay, he caught the green, but he'd be looking to try and get a good safety, create a chance if possible.
Agora a trocação de defesa.
Quase. That's a bit fortunate. Once he flicked on the way down to catch you on the way back. Lucky.
E aí, Luciano, bom dia, meu querido. Seja bem-vindo. Não, quem está comentando é o Ken Dort, o...
And it's forced a mistake.
Esse aqui tá falando é o John Virgo.
The last thing Dave Gilbert wanted.
E o quem tá comentando com ele é o Ken Dort.
In this third frame, having only, well, he didn't score a point. He spotted one red.
Virgo que não teve. Pescocinho torto, né? Where's the cue ball going?
Points to his name at the moment. Well, obviously Luca thinks he can get through to the black. And if he can, chance to pot the black and nudge the red that's just to the left of the black away. Make the black spot a lot clearer.
He's got to be careful here, particularly if he plays to the red that's closest to the left corner pocket. Doesn't want to be straight on this red, needs an angle when he has it. It's okay.
Eight.
Bonito, hein? Mas a plateia tá lotada, hein?
This is where you know when you Nine. You have your opponent, John, where he hasn't really settled. Mm. You've got off to a good start. You want to sort of compend it, make sure that he keeps him in the chair and makes another big break here, and it's possible.
Realmente, yeah, o Ken Dort falou a verdade.
And,
pode
you know,
ter um grande break agora.
He doesn't look like missing, does he? He doesn't look
like
he's
going
to rush a shot. He's got a nice pace around the table. And you sit there wondering, when am I going to get a chance?
And that's the hardest thing about playing snooker. No matter how good you're feeling coming into the match, just hasn't had a chance. Oh, it's gone wrong, is it?
Passou, cara.
Quickly.
20
passou lost the cue ball.
Pouquinho a mais.
Touching ball. Looks like end of break.
Touching ball. Epe! Grande Ricardo Pierre. Satisfação, meu querido. Que legal ter você com a gente aí, viu? Estamos aí. Bom dia. Essa galera do Holmes aí, para mim, vai ser sempre da família Holmes, hein?
Risky.
Show de bola, pé.
He doesn't really just want to drop to the top cushion here. Doesn't really gain any advantage. But sometimes you just got to contain the situation. Well, he's tried it the hard way, ooh, and that's what happens. Caught the bump. No need to play that shot.
Luca Brasil.
It was a risk that he didn't have to take. Now, Dave Gilbert.
A chance do Dave
Gilbert. Is that chance you were looking for?
Ele não conseguia jogar a bola direto lá para cima, porque senão ia balançar a bola 2, estava um totimbol. Por isso que ele tentou subir com a tabela. Vamos lá, David Gilbert.
Pode. First point.
Só a chance, scored. Hein, Mioguinho?
Para David Gilbert now. Was he on this black? He's having a good look at it. Yeah, I think he's okay. He can play it off two cushions for the red. It's closest to the black.
Será que ele vai fazer que nem o Glenn Dort falou? Duas tabelas? Seguindo duas tabelas? É, o homem manja mesmo, hein?
He's a lovely cue, Steve Gilbert.
Duas tabelas para pegar na caçapa 4.
Very free-flowing sort of cue action. See it? It's nice and easy. Oh, that didn't go in the middle of the pocket, and he's lost the cue ball.
That's it. O que o cara quis fazer, cara?
Yeah, watch the red here. Look where it goes into the right. Almost missed it. Because of that, he's lost position, and that's end of break.
Cara. Acabou a brincadeira. Ah, pelo amor de Deus, viu?
Yeah. And as Ken said, it's just because that pot didn't go in the middle of the pocket. You base your positional play and the pace in the cue ball on it going in the middle of the pocket, and he just caught it too thick and it took the pace out of the cue ball.
Nossa, mãe. Bola pegou no meio da tabela.
It's a shot he's always going to take on. If he got close, he'd wrap it in the jaws, he'd go safe.
Pegou.
Nowhere near the pot, he's left it on.
So Dave Gilbert
gets a second chance.
Olha isso.
Yeah, long way away from that. So another chance for Dave Gilbert to settle down into this match.
O Elton comprou o ingresso pro dia 24. Vai assistir o jogo do Sullivan. Na cara. Ele foi lá, achou o ingresso antes do sorteio. Comprou o ingresso. A moça perguntou, dia 22 ou 24? Ele, dia 24. Aí, duas horas depois, teve sorteio. O Sullivan vai jogar no horário que ele comprou o ingresso. E ele comprou o ingresso para sentar atrás do... Mais uma sorte, atrás do jogador. Naquela carreirinha ali, ó, do lado da escada. Na segunda, vai sentar no B18, B19 e B20. As poltronas.
É straightforward to judge this.
É que eu falei para ele que na fila tem o pessoal que desiste do ingresso, né? Daí vai lá e a bilheteria revende o ingresso.
He's obviously, the only one I can see.
Mas dia 24 nós vamos ver o Elton Faria na arquibancada. Atrás do Sul.
Of all the extensions that are available. Thinish cut. Missable.
É uma bola missable, hein? É uma bola missable. É uma bola missable, errou.
Yeah, they're always missable. Then it's what we call playing into a blind pocket. You can see the cue ball, you see the object ball, but you haven't got the pocket in your eye line. And it found him out.
Yeah, it was that first red, wasn't it, John? He really needed to be on the yellow there. The blue was a lot more difficult to try and make something a little bit more easier for himself. Once again, the speed of the table. Very hard to hold a cue ball.
Oh, okay, George, fuck, a mesa muito rápida.
Just ran on. He's okay with the rest. He's a decent rest player, but yeah, a little shake of the head. He can't believe how far the cue ball has traveled.
Yeah, and of course, with it being a thinnish contact, you feel he's got to play a cannon of some kind. So needs a bit of luck. Got the pot. Oh, and he'll settle for that. He just flipped the red. And it's perfect.
Coquinha na bola vermelha ajudou, hein?
Eight. Nine.
Well, once again, not the best angle on the black. He wanted to be a little bit lower with the cue ball.
Manchado, so já que os caras vêm.
Develop a red or two. There's nothing available into this right corner pocket.
Pelo intervalo, os caras vão varrer a mesa.
We're gonna play for red into the center, maybe. Maybe he's playing for red into the left center pocket.
Yeah, but you'd think trickier than he would have liked.
16.
No meio.
Oh, is he not certain he can hit enough of it? Maybe he wasn't on it.
Luca Brasil, 16.
Anyway, it was a chance.
Mais uma chance.
He didn't take. So, third chance now, third opportunity to clinch this frame for Dave Gilbert. I feel for his confidence, he needs to take it.
Oh.
One. Once again, could have traveled with that cue ball a little bit further for blue or yellow, so a little bit more work to do with the cue ball. Down for one of the reds in the middle of this pack. This looks pretty good. Let's judge this nicely. Good shot,
boa
that.
Boa bola. Bom controle de branca.
Five.
You wouldn't say this is a must-win frame for Dave Gilbert so early on, but I totally agree with you, John. Just to settle down. You know, to settle down into this match, even though it's best of 19, you want to get your first frame on the board as early as possible. And this is a wonderful chance. He's going to have to make one good
12.
Sort of connection on those three reds just beneath the pink to bring them into 13. Play. And he's got a lovely angle on the black now.
Those
two reds directly above the black. A little cannon into those. He'll be on the other red into the corner.
Dave, I'd heard 20. A lot about him. Was in 2019 when he reached the semi-final, lost to John Higgins in a tight match. So no disgrace there, but I think he'll agree that he's not really pushed on from that.
21.
He puts it down sometimes to his temperament.
Sure,
well, he'd know better than me. But I always think the qualifiers come in match sharp. I mean, don't get me wrong, we've not seen any of them in the first two frames, but I was expecting a good performance from him.
Watching him play against Zhao Guodong in the final qualifying match. She won.
24.
And he played very, very well. As I said, he's a quality player, a former top 16 player. Been to the semi, and he's got a. He's blessed with a lovely cue action. Pai
do céu, second pass.
29.
Passou. Olha aí, rapaz.
No problem with the red. It pots into the same corner pocket where the pink is going.
Olha a chance do Wally, cara.
36.
Bom dia, Daniel. Ó, Daniel, chega deixando um joinha, hein? Olha a chance do menino, cara. Que legal. Dezoito pontos à frente, 27 tem na mesa.
45.
Valeu, Daniel.
Well, he had a chance in this round, did Luca?
48.
And he knows the longer he could have kept Gilbert on nil,
boy,
the
boy.
More frustration and pressure you heap on your opponent. And Dave 52. Gilbert, well, he'd just been mighty relieved to get his first frame on the scoreboard. He's needed a few chances, don't get me wrong.
Ô, Vili, o Daniel é um torcedor fã número um do Ding, cara. O Daniel falou que o Ding vai ser campeão esse ano.
63.
É, Daniel, a turma tá economizando.
Nice contribution of 70 there from Dave Gilbert. He's on the scoreboard.
Ô, Vili, é o Dinguinho, né, Daniel? O Dinguinho.
Para você que gosta de produtos de qualidade, conheça as solas MP Tips, fabricadas de forma artesanal, um produto nacional, feitas em couro de búfalo com durezas que vão de média a dura. E sob encomenda, você pode escolher a dureza da sua sola. Também temos solas laminadas feitas com couro de porco. Entre em contato com o Pedro Mendonça, melhore seu jogo com produtos de qualidade.
Último frame, tem um intervalo de 15 minutos agora, hein, galera? É o tempo de eu fazer meu café. Né? 4 frames, um intervalo.
Yeah, I don't think he's wearing his lucky socks today. He used to wear the old black and white socks, John. During that run to the World Championship. Quite a long way away and gifted a chance. That was very, very high tariff stuff from Dave Gilbert. He'd be disappointed.
Solid pot there from Luca and perfect angle on the blue. I feel Dave Gilbert there. Okay, he felt he was forced into it, couldn't see a safety shot, but as Ken said, it was fraught with danger. I maybe would have thought and tried to find another way to solve the problem. Anyway,
Six. It's
gone now. And good chance for Luca. His second interval after this frame.
Good chance que o Luca tem agora, hein?
7.
É isso aí, Vini. Bolão.
Little bit short for the red. It's got an angle. Be going into a red here.
Palpite pro campeão, pro vice-campeão. Oh. Que well. Isso, cara?
Red's everywhere. I tell you what, he's had a right result there, John. He's got away with that.
E já começou daquela aquela estacada. Típico do Luca Bressel, né, cara?
Yeah, considering Ken, everything, nearly everything moved. And as you say, he's not left anything that's appetizing, shall we say, for Dave. I mean, he's looking at this red.
Kind of fofarrão,
I assume he's going to hit it into another one and screw back to the bought cushion. He's not playing a pot on this, I don't think. Well, that's what he was playing to hit the red into another red. He missed that, but he's got a good cue ball. And that was the main object of the exercise.
É, cara. Muito estranho, meu filho. Ele dá umas tacadas que... Coisas do Bressel, cara.
That was risky, but once again, good cue ball. And the red that he hit is enough reds to keep it at the other half of the table. So Dave Gilbert once again now with a problem. This isn't a straightforward safety. Possible pot to the left middle, but surely much too risky. So playing the containing safety, but to my mind, he was always going to leave a pot on playing that. Maybe there wasn't another shot to play, but there's a shot on here for Luca.
Well, boy.
One.
Just gone a little bit. Oh, he might have doubled this.
Luca Brissell
wasn't playing
one.
The double, just trying to get that cue ball close to the ball cushion.
Vamos ver como é que tá o jogo do Jean
Leander. I think there was a time last year that he might have played the pot on the yellow there, but I think
Rapaz,
Gilbert's gonna have to work for his chances.
Jean Guiana tá tomando 2-0 do Jack Jones, hein?
Too thin.
Ah, que isso. Oh, Wally, não faz isso, Wally.
Now then, this red.
Cara, 2-0 do Jack Jones em cima do Jean Guiana.
Well, you can probably see it better from there. The pocket won't take it. As you see, narrow angle. No.
No.
No, so that mistake from Dave Gilbert.
Ai, Bressel, Bressel, você ganha mais dinheiro perdendo do que ganhando, cara. Não é possível, cara.
He's got to play that with a bit more pace, that if he does miss the red, that it goes by the middle pocket.
Tá jogando pro David Gilbert ganhar o jogo, ganhar o frame.
Okay. Makes the pot a little bit more difficult, but you shouldn't be leaving the red over the middle if you miss it.
Que tacada mais excelente, cara.
Not straightforward for Dave Gilbert here. Red, no problem. But yeah, he's got to negotiate the path to the cue ball, back up the line towards that yellow and black.
I won't want to overcomplicate this. I mean, basically what he's got to do, he's got to pot the red and then play it with enough pace. There's a couple of reds either side of the black and yellow. You know, you can't precisely judge the cannon, but just play in that area. You'd be unlucky not to be on a colour. Just make certain you get the pace of this shot right.
This looks pretty good.
That's okay, he's on the yellow. That's all he had to do, and now he can go to work.
É, Manuel, nem o Adinho, verdade. Mas é o Bressel, né, cara?
Yeah, well, popping this red into the left center, he'd be able to open up the black to the same pocket.
Four.
Don't know what happened there.
He
won't be happy with that, I promise you.
Yeah, about David Gilbert fazendo as coisas
com a middle pocket. Just the cannon nicely. Good shot. Backing prime position.
11.
It's all right.
17.
Some of these where you're just playing off the side cushion, so you just want to be careful. You don't really be straight on the black.
18.
No, it looks like he's got just enough angle to stun up for the next red. Only just. 5. And you get these mini sessions, Ken, don't you? And I think Luca, of the two, if he does go into the mini sessions, will all square. It's like he's playing unbelievable snooker the first two frames and 26. Not got much to show for it.
Yeah, he'd be disappointed. I think he's missed the chance in that third frame and indeed this frame.
Meu Deus, cara. Vamos lá, vamos fechar esse frame.
And the fact that he had Dave Gilbert rooted to his chair for a couple of frames without potting the ball, he hadn't settled down.
His heart was in his mouth. Is it still in his mouth? I'm looking at his body language. He's run too far. So much margin for error, and he's just overrun. Now, the red he's closest to is eyeing it up to the far left corner. That would be a little bit of a result if that is available. But it's certainly not what he played for. There you see it, but so close together. Got to be careful.
Yeah, he's got to play it with a little bit of pace, isn't he, as well? So a push shot is
you'd
a possibility. Well, is he on this red? Well, that doesn't look like he is, but he might be able to swerve it slightly. Maybe he is on it. Maybe it's just enough. Yeah, he just had enough of it. His hand went up. He didn't think he was on it initially.
Forty-two.
I'll just overrun that a little bit, but I'm just looking at those two reds below the pink. He's going to need, so I don't think they're available, so he may as well play a little soft cannon into the pink. You think he's bound to be on the red to the right middle. Just a gentle cannon.
43.
And that's fine. So now all the reds he needs to clinch this fourth frame, they're in the open.
47. 48. Yeah, watch when he pots this red. You'll see the hand go up apologetically to say, well, I was lucky to be on that red.
54.
Wouldn't have apologized.
Yeah, by 51 pontos na mesa.
Not for potting the ball that you played for. But yeah, it just shows you this game all about fractions, isn't it? And the fractions favour them there. And I think this is a big frame. I think this
61.
Match now, which finishes this evening, could be a close one.
62.
Wonderful session of snooker. Good breaks. 91, 134 from Luca Bissell. 70. And the last frame from Dave Gilbert.
66. 69.
This break is 69 and probably a little bit more to come.
2-2.
Black to take the red out, so he may play for the double on the red.
2-2. Intervalo pro café.
Oh, he hasn't gone far enough with the cue ball, so it'll be a hit and hope.
77.
Be calling all pockets for this. Well, he's trying to cut it into the yellow pocket, but it's not there. But still a wonderful break of 77 from Dave Gilbert. He was 2-0 down. We're back on parity terms. It's 2-2 against the world champion.
Fala pessoal, pra gente que gosta desse nosso esporte, sabe o quanto é difícil encontrar links que contenham lives, jogos ao vivo. É comum a gente ver nos grupos do WhatsApp perguntas do tipo, alguém tem um link? Onde que tá assistindo? Onde que eu posso assistir? E isso você encontra aqui no nosso canal Pizza Pava Sinuca. Você pode fazer parte do nosso grupo de membros do canal, onde você tem acesso a conteúdos exclusivos, transmissões ao vivo exclusivas. Um abraço!